Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to add floodlight text to a building or wall. For your convenience, I provided this photo of the United Nations building in New York that you could use for this project. In addition, I provided a link to this font. However, feel free to use any font you like. Their links are in my video's description or project files. The first step is to add text we want on the building. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. We want white to be our foreground color, so we'll invert the colors. To do this, press X or click this icon. Open your horizontal type tool and type picker. Pick a font you like. I'll use Altirabro Pixel. For its size, I'll type in 192 points. However, feel free to adjust this number based on the font you pick and the number of characters in your text. Make the aliasing smooth. I'll choose Center Alignment. Click on your document and type out your text. If you want to adjust the spacing between the lines of text, known as leading, double-click the large T on the text layer to highlight all your text, and click the character paragraph icon or go to Window and Character. Hover your cursor over the leading icon, and when it changes into a scrubby slider, drag it to the right or left. Open your Move tool and position your text over the building. We can close the character panel now. Press Ctrl or Command A to select the text, and Ctrl or Command C to copy it. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Hide the text layer and make the photo active. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Go to Filter and Vanishing Point. I did an in-depth tutorial on Vanishing Point, so if you'd like to watch it, I provided its link in my video's description. If you want to zoom into the image, click the magnifying glass icon. With the Create Plane tool active, click on a corner of the building, release, and click on another corner. Release again, and click a bottom side that follows the perspective of the building. Release, and click the opposite side again, following the perspective. If the grid is red or yellow, reposition any of the corners until the grid turns blue. We can extend any of the sides by simply going to the middle anchor point and dragging it. Press Ctrl or Command V to paste your text onto your image. Drag it into the grid, which immediately matches the perspective to the building. To fit it inside the grid, click the Transform icon and drag a corner or a side and reposition it. Continue to finesse its size, shape, and position until you like the way it looks over the building. Hide layer 1 and make the photo active. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. We'll brighten the copy, but before we do, let's convert it into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Levels. We want the adjustment level to affect just the copy and not the original photo. However, since adjustment layers affect all the layers below them in the Layers panel, we need to clip it or restrict it to the layer below it. To do this, click the Clipping Mask icon, or you can go to Layer and Create Clipping Mask. For the Input Shadows level, type in 17, and for the Input Highlights, type in 46. Control or Command click the thumbnail of Layer 1 to make a selection of our text and perspective, and make the background copy active. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection. Make the background copy active, and go to Image, Adjustments, and Shadows Highlights. If you don't see the entire window, check Show More Options. For this image, make the shadows amount 20% and the color 0. Double-click the layer mask and feather it 3 pixels. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.